Welcome back. In this video, we are going to solve problem 14-25 that is taken from chapter number 14, Energy Methods, and book name is Mechanics of Material by R.C. Hibbeler. So statement is determine the horizontal displacement of joint B, the member of truss are A992 steel bar, each with a cross-sectional area of 2500 square millimeter. So you can see this is a truss and there is a load of 15 kilonewton applied at point B. So you have to determine, due to this load, this point B will move toward this. So this is the horizontal displacement of point B. So you have to find this displacement of point B. So let's start with the solution. So this topic comes under the category of conservation of energy, and you know that due to this external load, this point B will move to this distance, clear delta B, which is the external work, because force into this distance is work, which is the external work that is stored in the form of strain energy. So this strain energy, external work due to external load will be stored in the form of external strain energy that will be equal to the axial strain energy in this truss. So the main basic equation is this one. So we'll apply this equation. So let's start with the solution. So first step is that you have to find the forces in each member of truss by using my method of joint. Why? Because we should know the axial load in each member so that we can apply the strain energy due to axial loading. So first what we will do is that we will take joint B. So you can see this is joint B. So due to this load, this will cause this member to compress. As a result, this member will exert load FAB on point B is in this direction. Similarly, due to this point B will move, this will be in elongation. As a result, this member will apply load in this direction, which will be FBD. So I will draw it. This is point B, clear. So this is the load, which is 15 kilonewton. The member FAB will apply load in this direction, FAB. And the member FBD will apply load in downward direction. Clear? So we'll find this by using equation of equilibrium. So first equation of equilibrium is that sum of all forces along x direction must be equal to zero and force in towards right is positive. So plus FAB minus 15 is equal to zero. So FAB is equal to 15 kilonewton. Now you can see that this is the force that this member applies on joint B. As a result, the force in this member will be compressive one. Clear? So I will write it. This is in compression. This member FAB is in compression. Now we'll apply another equation that sum of all forces along y direction must be equal to zero and upward force is taken as positive. So you can see only force FBD is acting. There is no other force. So it means that FBD is equal to zero. Okay. Now this is for joint B. Okay. We will move toward joint A. So you can see this is joint A. This is joint A. So the member, this member is exerting a force on joint A is this. This is FAB. Now, due to this load, this member will exert force in this direction. This will be FAD. And this member will also exert a force in this direction. This will be FAC. Clear? So we will draw the free body diagram. This is point A. You have this FAB, which is in this direction. So FAB is, we have calculated that is 15 kilonewton. Clear? So this is FAC, which is not known. Clear? And this load is FAD. FAD. Okay, now you can see this length is 2 and this is 1.5. So if I draw a right angle triangle over here, clear? So this is right angle triangle. If I multiply it with 2 and this with 2, so this become equal to 4, this will become 3, and this will be 5. So this is standard right angle triangle. So I will draw this right angle triangle over here as well, so that we can get its horizontal and vertical component, 4, 3, and 5. Now we will apply equation of equilibrium. So what is the equation of equilibrium? Is that sum of all forces along x direction must be equal to 0 and force toward right side is taken as positive. So FAB, which is minus 15, now you can see this will have two components. One is this one and other one is this one. So I will draw it by using two colors, different color. One is this component and other one is this component. So this component will be equal to FAD into 4 over 5. Clear? And this component is equal to FAD 3 over 5 because this is perpendicular. How? Because you can see this is theta. So if you take sine theta, so sine theta is equal to 3 over 5 and cos theta is equal to 4 over 5. So this is the horizontal component, which is equal to fx, FAD x component, which is equal to FAD cos theta. So if you replace cos theta, so it will be equal to FAD 4 over 5. And same here, this is equal to FAD sin theta, and sin theta is 3 over 5. Now you can apply equation of equilibrium. So this plus FAD 4 over 5 is equal to 0. So from here, FAD will be equal to 4 over 5 is equal to 15. So FAD will be equal to 18.75 kilonewton. Okay. This FAD will be in tension. Why? Because you can see due to this load, clear, there will be elongation in FAD. So this FAD will be in tension. Okay. Now we will move toward finding another force, that we will apply sum of all forces along y direction must be equal to 0 and upward force is taken as positive. So from here, FAC minus FAD into 3 over 5 is equal to 0. So you can see FAD, we have F value, FAC is equal to FAD into 3 over 5. So FAD is 18.75 into 3 by 5. So when you solve this, you will get FAC comes out to be 11.25 kilonewton. Okay. Since this force is FAC is applying force in FAC is applying force in this downward direction, upward direction. So the force in this member FAC will be in downward. That means it is in compression. The previous one was about this FAD. Okay, so make a correction over there. So I will write here, this is in compression. Now we'll move toward joint C. So we will find the forces for joint C. Joint C. So you can see that this is your joint C. This is your joint C, where you have a normal force CY, clear, and there is a downward force, which is FAC we have calculated, and this FCD will be in this direction. So we will draw this joint C. So let this is your point C. So upward reaction force is CY, clear. The downward force is FAC, clear. And the horizontal force is FCD. Okay. So we know this. We do not need this, because this we are only finding the forces in members. So we will apply equation of equilibrium, that sum of all forces along x direction must be equal to 0 and force in this direction is taken as positive. So there is only horizontal force FCD, there is no other force, so it means that FCD is equal to 0. Now you can check it that we have how much member? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And we have find the 5 forces. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 forces in each member. So what we are going to do is that we will find the strain energy due to axial loading, and that is equal to sum of n square L divided by 2 AE. So what we are going to do is that we will take 1 over 2 AE outside, and we will left with sum of n square multiplied by L. So for 5 different member, I will write 1 over 2 area is given as 2500 into 10 to the power minus 6. So 2500 into 10 to the power minus 6 into E. E is 200 gigapascal into 10 to the power 9. You can check it from the property table. Let me show you. You can see for A992, E is 200 gigapascal. Okay. Now what we will do is that we will multiply forces in each. So starting from this force FAB, 15 kilonewton. So FAB is 15 kilonewton, 15 into 10 to the power 3 whole square multiplied by length of AB, which is 2 meter. So I will write it multiply by 2. Plus the second force is FBD, which is 0. So 0 square multiplied by length of FBD is 1.5. So 1.5. Plus third force is this one, which is FAD. So FAD is 18.75 into 10 to the power 3 multiplied by its length. So its length will be 5 by using Pythagoras theorem. Okay, not 7.5. This is 2. This is 1.5. So it will be 2.5 meter. Okay. So multiply by 2.5. Plus the fourth force is this FAC. So 11.25 into 10 to the power 3. Whole square multiply by length of AC. So AC is length 1.5 meter. So I will write 1.5 meter. And the last force is FCD, which is 0, and 0 multiplied by its length will be 0. So when you solve this, you will get the strain energy due to axial loading comes out to be, it will be 1.51875 joules. Now this is the strain energy due to axial loading, and we will find the strain energy due to external work, which will be equal to this external force and the displacement delta H, horizontal displacement of delta B. So that will be equal to 15 into 10 to the power 3 multiplied by delta H of B. Now by using law of conservation of energy, we will use this equation that UE is equal to UAI. So just put the value 1.51875 is equal to 1.5 into delta H B. Okay, one more correction is that due to this external work, this formula is 1 over 2 multiplied by load into the horizontal displacement. So make correction over here that UE is equal to 1 over 2 external load P into horizontal displacement. So I will write 1 over 2 as well over here. Clear? And from here, you will get delta HB will be equal to 2 multiplied by 1.51875 divided by 1.5. and that comes out to be 0.2025 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter. Or you can see that horizontal distance or displacement of point B will be equal to 0.2025 millimeter, which is the answer of our this question. And as we know that 1.5 kilonewtons, so I will multiply it with 10 to the power 3 as well, so that you should have this answer. And this was all about this problem 14-25. I hope you have enjoyed this video and you have learned from it. Those who are new to my channel, then subscribe it and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you can get notification about my latest videos. If you have any question, you can ask me in comment section. Also share my videos with your friends and help me in growing further. Thank you for watching.